you have used DaVinci Resolve for a while, you find that there are two text effects to use, the regular text and the text plus. But if you use DaVinci long enough, you will also realize no one is using the regular text, everyone is using the text plus. And I've seen a lot of videos talking about the basic stuff of the text plus, and most people will just use it to create the normal text on the screen, right? Well, you know, it actually can do a lot more than what you think. So in today's video, I'm going to show you some advanced things about the text plus that I've never heard people talking about, and you might also not know that it's capable of. And the last one probably going to blow your mind. So without further ado, let's go. You probably know this one. I remember back in the day when I just starting out and don't know anything about the DaVinci Resolve at all, I made this classic mistake that I believe everyone does. Is using spacebar to align the word. And I'll do it until it's perfectly aligned. No shame. Everyone has a starting point. So for a more efficient way to add space, is use tab spacing, which you will also need to replace all of your spacebar with a tab key to separate the words. Then at the bottom of the inspector, there's a tab spacing adjustment, where you can then now adjust the position and the alignment of each word for each line. One way you can use this for is you manually adjust the position of each tab. Or let's say if you want it to have an equal space between your first and your last word, you just need to find the last tab of your text for each line, then divide that number by the number of tabs that you have. In this case, it's tab number 3. So your first gap is gonna be divided by 3. Then your second gap should be double the position of your first one. Then you can use that and create an expression by right-click on the position adjustment and select expression. Then type in tab 3 position, divide by 3 for your first tab, and multiply the whole thing by 2 on your second tab. Then no matter how much you adjust the last tab, it will also change position of the words between to have an equal space. So remember, use the tab key and never use the space bar ever again. Now when you start being serious about video editing, you're gonna find yourself in a situation where you need to create some kind of timer. And what most people do, they will just cut the text to last only a second and then duplicate it for every other second they want, which is a lot of work, right? Or if they're experienced enough, they will know that they can use keyframes on the text box, then they can change the text every second, which is less work than before, but still a lot of work. Here's what you can do. You can use a timecode in the text plus. And in order for you to access that, you need to right click on the text box and choose timecode. Now it will create a timer for you based on the length. So if you adjust the length, it will auto adjust the timer as well. And if you want to customize the timer, you can do that by going into the Fusion page. Then open the inspector to the modifiers. Then you can untick whatever elements you don't want. Or if you want it to be a countdown timer, you can create a compound clip, then reverse the speed. And now that we talk about the timer, there's another one that also create a timer for you. This one is a lot more versatile and a lot more about timer than the previous one. Text timer. Basically, you do the same as the timecode, but choose text timer instead. Then add the modifiers in the Fusion page. You can choose a countdown, a timer, or a clock, which basically will just take the current time that you set on your computer. Then you set the timer and hit the start button. It will start the timer and never stop until you hit the button again. Now, if you want to also make it a countdown timer, you will need to keyframe it, but you don't have to be precise like you normally do. You just need to set the keyframe at the beginning and at the end. Then it will adjust the timer to perfectly fit the length of the clip, so you don't have to duplicate your text or keyframe your text for every second anymore. Next one. I never found myself using this one before, but if you find yourself have a boring text animation, this might help. Follower. Similar to the previous one, you right-click on the text box, this time you select Follower. Then you go to the Fusion page, under Inspector, go to Modifiers. Then create any keyframes under the text page, transform page, or shading page. Right now it still works as a normal keyframe, right? But the magic is happening when you adjust the things on the timing page, which you can change the order of the keyframes as shown on the screen. Then you increase the delay to whatever you want. You can then now get a more fancy text animation to use on your projects. I remember there's one text effect that's pretty hard to create. Well, actually not hard, but pretty time consuming to create if you do it manually. That is the shuffle text effect, where you want to make it look like it is shuffling the text until it's find the right text. Normally, if you break down the effects and think about the structure a little bit, you're gonna figure out that you need to keyframe and change each letter frame by frame. But not anymore. You can do that within seconds with text scramble. All you have to do is similar to the timer. Right click and choose Text Scramble. Then under the modifiers on the Fusion page, you get to choose the randomness. You can then now keyframe it to the point where you want the text to be shown. Now you get the shuffle text effects without you doing it manually for each frame. Save you a lot of time, right? Now the last one is the effects that I recently found from PJ Channel. And I'm pretty sure this one gonna impact the entire DaVinci Resolve users group. You know, a lot of the time when I want to create some kind of advanced text animation, the normal workflow is you take your own text that you created using Text Plus. Then you go to the Fusion page and trace the outline by hand. The problem with this is it's very boring and very time consuming. Pretty sure you can feel that too, right? So Vector Snapshot can help you. But before that, you'll need a reactor. The link will be down below. You get a Lua file, then you drag that to the Fusion page to install it. And then inside Reactor, install Vector Snapshot. What it allows you to do is place your own text or any PNG file, then whatever outline you want to create, change it to a white color. If your PNG has a lot of color, you can make it black and white by connecting it to a background node. Then change the color to white and change the channel in the setting page to luminance. Then play with the low and high values below until you get the cleanest white to trace the outline. Then you hit Ctrl Shift Space and find Vector Snapshot, then hit Enter. It will generate a vector file. Then when you import that vector file back to the Fusion page, it will automatically trace all the outlines for you. You can then now use that outline to make some insane text animation without having to trace it line by line. Of course, with all of these text effects, you can already create a bunch of creative animation, but I haven't mentioned about sound effects yet. That is also very important for your video. So the next thing you're gonna need is this video where I gather all of the free websites for finding high quality assets, such as sound effects, overlay, movie clips, and much more, which are very important elements to fulfill your creative works. And remember to like and subscribe. Bye.